Hi, welcome back. My name is Dr. Rabia Kure. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make emulsifications as lotions and creams using oils or butters and water. First and foremost, I want to run you through the tools or equipment that you would need to make body lotions or whatever lotions and creams. You need weighing scales, digital weighing scales. This is a large capacity weighing scale, and this is a small capacity weighing scale. You need either of them or both of them at the same time, depending on the volume of product you are making. In the absence of weighing scales, of digital weighing scales, you could use measuring cups and spoons. They come in sets of different sizes, each size is written on each piece. So when you are using cups and spoons, you'll be your weight will be by volume, so you stick to that to whatever ratio you are using. Another important equipment for making lotions and creams is a stick blender. It's a very powerful handheld tool. It does a very great job of mixing the oils or fats with the water. If you use your hand, you are going to do a lot of work, but with this, within minutes, the emulsification is ready. And if you don't have a stick blender, you could use your regular blender. Some people do that. Some people also use whisk, but I don't like the idea of using a whisk because it incorporates too much air into your emulsion, and that may make your product spoil very fast. That is, it might reduce the shelf life of your product. Next, we need our containers to put the final product. You have different containers you can use. You have jars. You could use jars for, this is especially good for thick creams. You can use pump bottles. These are okay for lotions. You can also use spray bottles. If you make very light lotions that you want to be spraying onto your skin, it's particularly good maybe for sunscreen. If you're making a sunscreen emulsion, you could use these tiny pots. For example, if you're making an eye cream, this would be ideal. They are readily available for purchasing. You might need a funnel to package your lotion. Makes it easy to pour the lotion into the bottles, or you need containers to heat. You could use plastic containers. You could use Pyrex containers or stainless steel containers. Please do not use glass. Don't heat glass. And then do not use aluminium containers. So next, we'll move on to the ingredients. Like we said, we are combining both water and oils or fats. So you need your water, clean water, if possible sterile water or clean catch rain water. Please do not use tap water, because tap water has been processed with chemicals and may contain chemicals that would interfere with your lotion or cream, or may contaminate your lotion or cream. You could use either water alone, or you can combine water with hydrosols, that's flower water, like rose flower water, and neroli, that's bitter orange flower water. We use calendula flower water. There are so many types available in the stores. Or you could use flower water alone in place of water. So whatever you are making, the choice is yours. Then that's that for waters. We have our oils. There are so many types of oils available in the market. The choice is yours. We have sunflower oil. coconut oil, this is rosemary oil, it's particularly good for the skin and hair. We have jojoba oil, which is actually a liquid wax and is excellent for the skin. This is vitamin E oil. And you have our butters. This is shea butter. I'll be using only shea butter for this project. You could also use cocoa butter, mango butter, avocado butter, jojoba butter. So many types of butters are available. Use the one you can easily get, or the one that suits the purpose for which you are making the cream or lotion. Next, okay, an important point about the oils and butters. Each has its unique properties. Some oils are dry oils, some are thick and give very good protective barriers. They have different rates of absorption, and then they also have different extents or degrees of absorption. They have different shelf lives too. Some have shelf lives as low as 6 months, while some have shelf lives as high as 2 to 5 years. The butters especially, some can last up to 5 years. So pay attention to the shelf life of the oil or butter you are using. If you use an oil with a shelf life of 6 months, your product will last just 6 months. That's your product will have a shelf life of 6 months. If you use an oil with a shelf life of 2 years, then your product, if well preserved, will have a shelf life of 2 years, and so on and so forth. So please pay attention to that. Then if you want to make a product for somebody with oily skin, you should use a dry oil. If you want to make a product for somebody with dry skin, you should use an oil with very good that provides good protective barrier and is not rapidly absorbed by the skin. So pay attention to the different properties of the oils and butters you are using. A very important ingredient is the emulsification wax, also known as e-wax. This is the ingredient that makes it possible for us to combine oils or fats with water. If you do not include an emulsification wax in your lotion or cream, even if it appears to have blended initially, the product will likely separate later into oil and water again. So please make sure you use an emulsification wax. There are different types and available in the market. I want to state that some people also use beeswax as an emulsifying agent. It works, but beeswax is not an emulsifying agent. I've not used it personally, so I can't really say my experience with it or encourage anyone to use it. Next, very important ingredient is a preservative. This is Optifine. Sorry, the labeling is a bit bad. You need a preservative if you are making any product containing water, because if you include water in any product, it's most likely going to spoil soon. So please endeavor to include a preservative. There are different types. Look for natural organic ones. Avoid the ones that have been banned globally, the ones that have been seen to be harmful, like formalin or formalin releasing preservatives. If you don't include a preservative in your cream or lotion, if you put it in the fridge, it may last up to 4 weeks. But with a preservative, and then based on the shelf life of your oil, your product may last up to 2 years on the shelf. So please, please and please include a preservative. Then other ingredients, they are optional. Some are active ingredients. You include them for desired benefits. An example is vegetable glycerin, It's water soluble, it's a humectant, it attracts water to itself. So if you include it in your cream or lotion, it's going to increase or boost the moisturizing ability of your cream or lotion. We have menthol crystals. You could add this to your cream or lotion you are making, say for pain relief or to soothe skin irritation or itching. These are colorings. You could add a little bit of color to your cream or lotion. This is gold sparkle mica. Doesn't color intensely, but can give your cream or lotion some shine. This is red, brick red oxide pigment. Just a tiny bit of it to give a pinkish coloration to your lotion or cream. You also have a yellow oxide pigments. So the choice is yours. You don't have to add a cream or coloring agent. And these are essential oils. To me, they are optional too. If you want to scent your product, you could add. Apart from their fragrance, essential oils also have beneficial properties. Some suited to specific conditions. Some are antibacterial, antifungal. Some suit irritation. Some are insect repellent. So look for them and use the one that suits you. You could use one alone or a combination of some of them to get a custom fragrance. This is vitamin E oil. It's optional too. It's antioxidant, so it's a good ingredient to add to your lotion. So that's about that. You have a wide range of active ingredients you could use. You could use aloe vera. You could add aloe vera. You could add sunscreen agents. Zinc oxide would provide some sunscreen. You could use collagen. You could use collagen is anti-aging. There are other anti-aging agents like fruit acids. You could include vitamins, other vitamins like vitamin A is good. Vitamin C is also good for skincare products. If your product is too watery, you could thicken it by adding a gum like xanthan gum or gum arabic. Those are natural gums. That's that for the ingredients. Before you start production, please wash and dry your equipment and tools. When they are dry, cleanse them with isopropyl alcohol. Make sure your formula is ready. You should have written out your formula before starting. So, we're going to start now. We have three phases. We have the oil phase, the water phase, and the cooling down phase. For the oil phase, you heat the oil, butters, emulsification wax, and the oil-soluble ingredients together, except the vitamin E and the active ingredients. So please do not heat vitamin E because heat will destroy the vitamin E, destroy the potency. The water soluble phase involves heating the water. The water phase involves heating the water and water soluble ingredients together. For this project, we are going to heat the water and glycerin together. Then the cooling down phase, as the name implies, is when the emulsion has cooled down to a certain degree, and that is the time you add the active ingredients, your preservative, and your essential oils. So we have our improvised double boiler. These are pots with water in them already boiling. If you are working with oils and fats, please do not place them directly over a heat source. Use a double boiler or an improvised double boiler. Okay, this is my coconut oil, shea butter, and emulsification wax measured together. Some people would like to first heat the emulsification wax or any wax they are using first before adding the oil and water, because it's a bit more difficult for the waxes to melt, and some people will not like to subject their oils and butters to prolonged heating. So the choice is yours. I'm heating the water already. So I'm heating the oils and the butter and emulsification wax in a separate improvised double boiler, and this is the water. So when the water is hot and the oils and butters and emulsification wax are completely melted, I'm going to combine both and blend with a stick blender. Okay, so stir a bit so that the melting will be faster. Can turn off the heat as soon as you see the ingredients have almost completely melted. Okay, so my water is hot and your oil, butter and emulsification wax have completely melted. I want to emphasize that you heat both the water phase and the oil phase to about 70 degrees centigrade. If you have a thermometer, you can check the temperatures. If not, just improvise and use an initiative. So I've poured the oil into the oil mixture or the oil phase into the water phase. You can see the mixture is yellowish. The oil phase took on the color of the shea butter, which has a yellowish color. Some shea butters are cream colored or white, so they may not look this yellowish if you use them to make in the oil phase, if you use them in the oil phase. So I'm going to blend now with a stick blender, and blending should be for like 3 to 5 minutes. Please make sure you use a deep bowl when blending so that your products will not splash all over the working surface. Okay, so this is our lotion. It's quite for now, it's quite watery for now. It will get thicker as it cools down. So for the ingredients, the emulsification wax usually should be between 5% and 25% of the oils, not of the total formula, between 5% and 25% of the oils. So if the total oil and butter volume is like 30 grams, the emulsification wax should be between 5% to 25% of that 30 grams. Then usually your oils and fats should make up anything between 1% and 30% of your lotion or cream. Between 1% and 30%, if you want very low oil, or if you want a cream or lotion with very low level of oils or almost oil free, use little quantity of oil. And if you want the end product to be quite greasy, use more oils. Again, if you want very thick product, use more butters and waxes. But if you don't want the product to be very thick, use less wax or more oils and less fat, less butter. So that's the trick behind what you may like to produce. Remember, lotion, watery lotion or very thin lotions, use more of oils and less wax. For thick creams or lotions, use more emulsification wax and more butters in your formulation. So you allow the product to cool gradually and stir it at intervals. Don't just leave it to cool down on its own completely. Stir it at intervals so that it won't form a block. Okay. So when it has cooled to a certain extent, to like 40 degrees centigrade or less, then you add your active ingredients, your essential oils, and a preservative. After that, the product has completely cooled down, you can then bottle the lotion or cream or package the cream. To measure my tea tree, essential orange oil, which I'll use to fragrance my product. I'll add neem oil for some antibacterial effect and anti-inflammatory effect. And I'm adding neem oil because I'm battling body acne, so I use neem oil to help fight body acne. Then my preservative. So I'm going to measure them and add. Okay, so I've added my essential oil and preservative and the neem oil. If you're making a lotion, say, to repel insects, you could add whatever you want to add. You could use an essential oil like citronella or lemongrass is very good for those. If you are making a lotion or cream for, say, muscle aches, you could add menthol crystals. And if you are making an anti-aging face cream, for example, you could add collagen. You could also add coenzyme Q10 or there are many other anti-aging agents or fruit acids. So the choice is yours. There are so many things you can make with this basic emulsion. So many products you can make with them. You can see the product is a lot thicker now because it has cooled down completely. So I'm going to package it. I will use a pump bottle. And this consistency is suitable for using a pump bottle. So this way I'm making use of it. So this is our lotion. You can see it's quite fluid. It's completely cooled down. You can make a much thicker product or even a less something less fluid. Something more fluid than this, particularly if you want to make a spray lotion. So that's that for our body lotion or our emulsion. So feel free to try to make something for yourself and remember to include all the ideas I gave in the process of formulating your own body lotion or cream. Thank you.